Good morning, students. I welcome you all once again to the MCOM first semester Indian Financial System subject for the video lesson. At the fag end of the unit 1, today we'll go for learning of the money markets and the monetary policies implementation in the Indian economy. As we all know that every country will have its own economic policy, and depending upon the economic policy, the monetary policy is going to be derived as well as designed and practiced. So if you observe the diagram, there is a concurrent influence between and among the various elements of the financial system or the economic system. So the economic policy is going to influence the monetary policy, and on the other hand, the practice of the monetary policy is going to influence the implementation of the economic policy, and also for further shaping and reshaping of the economic policy in future. So that's why when we go for learning about the monetary policy, it is also essential for us to know something about the economic policy. Particularly, the monetary policy is going to have main emphasis on the money supply and the cost and availability of the credit in the economy. But whereas, coming to the context of the economic policy, the main objectives of the economic policy is ensuring economic growth, establishing price stability, and providing social justice to all the people in the country. Undoubtedly, the money and the money markets play a major role in deriving the chief objectives of the economic policy. That's why there is a huge importance given to the monetary policy and kept in the hands of the regulator of the country, that is the Reserve Bank of India, in order to support the implementation of the economic policy from time to time. That's why the chief objectives of the economic policy are indirectly the chief objectives of the monetary policy also. Apart from that, the main objectives of the money monetary policy is the supply of money and the cost and availability of the credit, means the flow of funds to needy people, needy sectors, needy units and business entities in the economy. These are the main chief objectives of the monetary policy. So when this much of great responsibility has been associated with the monetary policy, now the regulator of the monetary policy or the executor of the monetary policy within the Indian economy or in the Indian financial system needs to have some key instruments or the methods or the regulatory movements to be conducted by the Reserve Bank of India as a regulator of the monetary policy of the country. So what are those instruments or the methods or methodologies through which the monetary policy is going to be controlled? If you see that there are a few number of instruments or the procedures have been adopted by the Reserve Bank of India, are going to be adopted continuously by the Reserve Bank of India in order to promote the main objective achievement within the Indian economy as well as in the Indian financial system. So what are those? Open market operations, cash reserve ratio, statutory liquidity ratio, bank rate, credit ceiling, credit authorization, borrowings variation, repo rate and reverse repo rate. So these are the various items through which generally the Reserve Bank of India will go for controlling of the money flow and the resources flow within the country. Apart from that, from time to time, whatever the suggestions received from the government of India, according to that also the RBI go for temporary practices or time related practices from time to time. Anyhow, these are the items which are quoted on this board as a in the diagram are going to be continuously being operated by the Reserve Bank of India as per the situation demanded. Now let us go for the understanding of one by one. The first one is open market operations. Whenever we talk about the word market, definitely the concern of supply and demand is going to be playing a vital role. So this open market operation is an instrument of money policy or the monetary policy which involves buying or selling of government securities from the public and the other banks. So the mechanism to influence the reserve position of the banks and yield on government securities and the cost of the bank credit. The RBI sells government securities to control the flow of credit and buys the government securities to increase the credit flow. Open market operations make bank rate policy effective and maintain stability in government securities market. Right? The next one is cash reserve ratio, which is also called as CRR. So what is the cash reserve ratio? You might have learned in your monetary economics as far as the bank's operations are concerned. Every branch of any bank is going to have a Reserve Bank of India's managed currency chest. So what is this currency chest actually? So this is an arrangement by the Reserve Bank of India in each and every bank branch at local level. So the currency chest is nothing but a secret locker or a fixed locker in which the money is being deposited, which is given an entry that the money is deposited with the Reserve Bank of India. Every day when the bank is opened, the manager will go for, in the want of money, take the money from the currency chest and gives the debit entry to the Reserve Bank of India account and informing that Reserve Bank of India, this much of money has been taken from the Reserve Bank of India currency chest. And that money will be in floating. Apart from that, whenever there is an excess money, that money is deposited again in the currency chest of the bank branch and a credit entry is given into the Reserve Bank of India currency chest account. Means the supply of money and the demand of money is going to be met by the respective branch in the particular branch account as well as in the Reserve Bank of India, such that the flow of money is going to be controlled here. So in such cases, what happens is, when there is a huge demand, the money is taken from RBI from the currency chest and went into circulation, and when there is not that much of demand, the money will be deposited in the currency chest. So such type of cash reserve ratio is one of the important element, and it is a certain percentage of bank deposits which banks are required to keep with the RBI in the form of reserves or balances. Higher the CRR with the RBI and lower will be the liquidity in the system, and so on. So on the opposite, lower the CRR, higher the circulation of money, right? The next one is statutory liquidity ratio. Statutory liquidity ratio means every financial institution has to maintain certain quantity of liquid assets with themselves at any point of time of their total time and demand liabilities. These assets have to be kept in non-cash form, such as government securities, precious metals, approved securities like bonds and certificates, etc. The ratio of the liquid assets to the time and demand assets is termed as the ratio. Now the next one is bank rate. Here, what is the bank rate? The bank rate is also known as the discount rate. It is the rate of interest charged by the RBI for providing funds or loans to the banking system. This banking system involves commercial and cooperative banks, industrial development banks, Indian industrial institutional financing, Exim Bank, and so on and so forth. So the funds are being provided either through lending directly or discounting or buying money market instruments like commercial bills and treasury bills, and the increase in bank rate increases the cost of borrowing by commercial banks, which results in the reduction in credit volume to the banks and hence declines the supply of money. Increase in the bank rate is the symbol of tightening of implementation of the monetary policy. The next one is credit ceiling. What is credit ceiling? Credit ceiling means in this operation, RBI issues prior information or direction that loans to the commercial banks will be given up to a certain limit. In this case, commercial banks will be tight enough in advancing loans to the public. They will allocate loans to limited sector or the needy sectors only, and the unnecessary loans are being cut out. The next one is credit authorization scheme. So the credit authorization scheme was introduced in November 1965 when P.C. Bhattacharya was the chairman of Reserve Bank of India. Under this instrument of credit regulation, RBI, as per the guidelines, authorizes the banks to advance loans for the desired sections of the loan demand is right. Next one is moral suasion. Moral suasion is nothing but it's a request by the Reserve Bank of India to the commercial banks to take so and so action that measures it so and so trend of the economy. Means as per the trends in the economy, the RBI gives a moral suggestion to the commercial banks and makes that this will be going to help to the management of the funds by the commercial banks. So the RBI may request commercial banks not to give loans for unproductive purpose, which does not add to economic growth but increases inflation. At the same time, as a part of the overall monetary policy implementation and the regulation of the demand and supply of funds in the economic system, the RBI will be giving on advices and suggestions from time to time to the commercial banks such that the flow of money is going to be controlled effectively. The next one is repo rate and the reverse repo rate. Repo rate is the rate at which the RBI lends its clients, generally again government securities. Reduction in repo rate helps the commercial banks to get money at a cheaper rate, and increase in the repo rate discourages the commercial banks to get money at the level of the RBI authorization. Henceforth, the increase in repo rate will increase the cost of borrowing, and lending of the banks will discourage to the public to borrow money and will encourage them to deposit. On the other hand, the reverse repo rate is just the quite against to the repo rate, right? This is what the reverse repo rate and the repo rate is going to be a tool to tighten the overall supply and demand of the money positions within the economy, and most of the times the inflation is going to be controlled with the help of the repo rate and the reverse repo rate. The repo rate and the reverse repo rate will be going to be controlled by Reserve Bank of India basing upon certain basis points from time to time, mostly either fortnightly or monthly. The repo rate and the reverse repo rate are going to influence the total overall money supply and demand within the monetary policy implementation within the economy. So this is what, how the money markets and the monetary policies are going to be have an intertwined effect while its performance within the Indian financial system. Tomorrow we'll go for learning of some other concepts in the unit 2 of the Indian financial system, in that is banking sector and the banking. Thank you very much for your kind, patient listening. Thank you.